Well, of course, I was absolutely delighted. First of all, I was very surprised. I didn't realize, to tell you the truth, that they recognized PhDs who did work in translational cancer, which I think is a wonderful thing. So I was very pleased, delighted, and I'm very honored to be here this evening. When I was an assistant professor, I received a letter from the National Cancer Institute asking me if I would look at the mechanism of action of this molecule called Taxol. Well, I had never heard of Taxol at the time. There was exactly one paper in the literature, which is now a landmark paper, which was published in the Journal of the American Chemical Society in 1971. By Mansu Gwani and Monroe Wall, the professors who had actually originally isolated the drug. And they published that paper, and they showed how they had isolated the drug and determined its structure, which was really an amazing feat in the 1960s. It's a very complex structure. Now, you probably wonder, why did they write that letter to me from the National Cancer Institute? I was an assistant professor, wasn't very well known. But already, I had become quite interested in natural products as a source of drugs for the treatment of cancer. And I had already published papers on camptothecin, on the epipodophyllin toxins, and we were actually studying bleomycin then. So with that background, they wrote to me and asked me if I could look at the mechanism of action of this drug. They already knew that it was toxic, cytotoxic to cells, because that's how it had been purified, and also the fact that it had shrunk tumors in mice that had malignancies. So I took it on as a challenge. I had a new graduate student at the time, Peter Schiff, and he was looking for a thesis project, and I said to him, okay, let's request 10 milligrams from the National Cancer Institute, and if at the end of 1 month it doesn't look interesting, we'll go for another thesis project. So that time has never come when it doesn't look interesting.